Hello friends, praise the Lord. Today we are going to see chapter 25 from the book of Genesis. The book of Genesis has got 50 chapters, so we are exactly midway, chapter 25. Here it says that Abraham married again. So this may be something new for us. So he had another wife whose name was Keturah, and through her there were 6 sons. So altogether 6 plus 2, Abraham had 8 sons. The 2 were Ishmael and Isaac. So all sons, okay? So this is just a fact, just an information. And then finally Abraham died at the age of 175. So that is all given in chapter 25. And Isaac and Ishmael buried him next to his wife Sarah's burial place. And just we saw that was the only place that was purchased by Abraham in the land of Canaan from the Hittites. So he did not have any other place, or they did not have any other place. So that was the place Abraham was buried, very next to Sarah. And next thing that comes in chapter 25 is about the descendants of Ishmael. So a small description is given about the descendants of Ishmael, and then about the family history of Isaac. I mean, that is where in detail the things are given in the Bible. So the family history of Isaac. So Isaac's wife was Rebecca, and Isaac married at the age of 40. So for a long time Rebecca did not have children, and she was very upset, and Isaac had prayed quite a lot, and therefore at the age of 60, when Isaac was 60, okay, he had children. Rebecca bore children, but they were twins, okay. And so when she conceived the twins, the two of them, it's given in the Bible that they were jostling in the womb, okay. So she was very uncomfortable about it, and she prayed, Lord, after a long time I'm getting children, and there are two of them, and which makes me very uncomfortable. And so when she was praying, she heard the Lord speaking to her, telling that there are two nations in your womb, and one will surpass the other, and the older one shall serve the younger one. So these are the revelations that she got while she was praying. There are two nations, one will surpass the other, and who will surpass? The older one will serve the younger. So the younger one will be. So this is how it was planned by God, okay. And why should it be like that, we can ask, but that's how the God's plan was. And finally, during the delivery time, the first one came out, that is the older one, obviously. It was reddish, the child was reddish in color with a lot of hairs on the body, and he was called as Esau. And the next one very shortly came out, holding on to the feet or the heel of the elder one, the older one. And because he was holding on to the heel of Esau, he was called as Jacob. Those days and all, they will give the names accordingly, however, okay. And so Isaac was 60 years old at that time, and so that's how Jacob and Esau were born. And now Esau and Jacob were growing. Esau became a skillful hunter, and Jacob was the second one, and very pampered child, was very silent child at home, not doing any, you know, not going for any job or anything, at home, just doing small chores along with the mother. And maybe because the Lord spoke to Rebecca that the younger one will surpass, or the younger one will overtake the older one. We do not know why. Rebecca had always had a soft corner with Jacob. Maybe not only because of that, because he was always the second child and the pampered one. So she was in fond of Jacob, whereas Isaac was in fond of Esau, because he was going out and hunting and helping the father. So there was a division among the attention between the parents itself. So that itself was a little wrong, but that's how it was, okay. And one day Esau came from the field. He was very sick and tired, and he saw Jacob cooking stew with his mother, and so he got the aroma of that, and since he was very tired, he said, please give me something to eat, I want it right now, I'm very sick and very tired. Maybe for fun, maybe Jacob said that, Jacob replied, give me your birthright and then I will give you this stew, okay, this food for you to eat. And Esau immediately said, take my birthright, no problem, who wants it? I'm hungry now, if I'm not having, I will die. So what's the point in having the birthright, so give me. So very easily, Esau just gave his birthright or denied or gave his big possession for the sake of a very small thing called as the stew. And so here we can see that when we look at this story or these things, we can see how cunning Jacob was, right? In a matter of seconds, he was able to get the birthright of Esau. And but then at the same time, we are also asked, we also should reflect the foolishness of Esau. Okay, see, for material things, for smaller desires, he was one person who was going behind the worldly things, forgetting about the greater things. Nowadays, we can think there are a lot of us who are actually going behind the worldly, temporary things that will die one day, but we are not focusing on the higher, spiritual, very important things that we have to save for the future, which is not happening. So so Esau is a reflection of people who are not spiritual but who are very worldly. So that is what happened. But whereas Jacob, though it is cunningness, his aim was higher. So that's what we have to look at, look from this. Maybe God knew that even before, and that's how he was telling that Jacob will surpass Esau and the younger one will overtake the elder one. Could be that. So here we have to, the final lesson that we have to understand is, we are, our three components are there. We are body, mind and soul. So the more worldly we are, the more we are working for now and then, which means we are a bodily person. But we have to ascend from that level to the mind level and from there to the spiritual level. So this is one thing that we can learn from this particular chapter, from the experience between Esau and Jacob. Okay, so next chapter we'll see in the next session. Thank you, God bless.